Greetings, friends. Welcome back to another Discover at Home. I'll be your host today. My name is Emily Heald. I'm the Water Program Coordinator here at the Discovery Center. Today we're going to be talking about purple loosestrife, but before we get too far into that, I want to tell you a couple interesting things. The first one is that we're still doing programming, but it's heavily modified due to COVID, and there are a lot of new things, so that program guide that we put out in the spring, it's not totally relevant right now. So what I'm going to need you to do is go to, get a pen, get a paper here, discoverycenter.net. Check out the program tab, and there's a whole list, calendar of events that says what we're doing, precautions that we're taking to that ensure everyone's safety, and all the fun things that we have planned for you. So check that out. Let's get into purple loosestrife. So this is what purple loosestrife looks like. So when you're looking to identify it, you're going to want to look at a couple different things. So the first one, the real obvious one when it's in flower, is to look for all these really bright pink purpley flowers growing really, really close to the stem. If you zoom in on them a little bit, they have five or six of those really pretty flowers. This one has six right here. And then the other things you can look for, if you move down the stem a little bit, if you kind of roll it between your fingers like this, you'll notice that it has an angled stem. So you'll definitely be able to feel those ridges on it, sometimes four or five, six different sides, but it definitely has a little bit of a square ridge to it. And then the last thing that you're going to want to look for is the pattern of how the leaves are growing. So they're growing opposite from each other. So you see these two are growing opposite from each other, one here, and then as you go up, these two are growing opposite from each other. These ones are growing opposite from each other with a little bit of a shoot coming out of it. And so that's how you identify purple loosestrife.
So purple loosestrife is originally from Europe and Asia. It was brought over to the United States because it's very pretty and people wanted to bring it over to plant in their gardens and plant it as an ornamental. And then it escaped from gardens from there. So once it establishes itself in a wetland, it can grow to be very tall. You can see that this plant right here is almost as tall as me. I'm 5'6", but some plants can grow up to be up to over 6 feet tall. And each individual plant, you can see this is all one individual plant here. They can have up to 50 stems. They can grow very robust and woody, almost more like a bush than what you think of as a flower. And each of these plants, you can see how many flowers are on them. And so you can imagine how many seeds that they produce. They produce millions and millions of pinhead size seeds that are really easily tracked around through different water movements, wind, people walking through them like we are now. That's why we're so careful about disinfecting all of our gear. So it can spread very easily. And because of that, it tends to, you know, like a lot of other invasive species, just take over. It's not the greatest habitat host for a lot of different wildlife and insect species. It can grow super densely and crowd out native species that other wildlife require to survive. So it's really just a nasty, nasty plant.
If there is a lot of purple loosestrife growing in one area like you can see here, it can be rather tedious and backbreaking to do any sort of hand removal. And so what we do in large areas like this, we come out and we clip the flower heads off of the purple loosestrife. That's not going to kill the plant, but it's going to prevent it from going to seed and spreading in other areas. So then also when we have areas that are really infested like this, we're going to release what are called cella beetles. And those are beetles that eat exclusively purple loosestrife. So we can release them out on areas like this and they will eat just the purple loosestrife and they will damage the plant enough so that it grows shorter and produces fewer seeds. And then hopefully native plants have a chance to grow and reestablish.
So that's a little bit of background about purple loosestrife, why it's a naughty plant to get in your wetland, why you don't want it there, and a couple removal and management options. And now we're going to give you a little bit of insight as to what it's actually like to be out doing this sort of field work, because it can be some really long days, we're in some really interesting areas, so we're going to show you.
rest of it. All right, I think that's the last of it.
All right, I'm pretty sure that was the last of it.
It's gotta be the last of it. I think this is the last of it.
I think that's the last of it, though.